coach. I thought it was a topsy-turvy, up and down, kind of a typical exhibition game. Tip your cap to Lenoir-Rhyne. They hung in there. They countered. They had great transition today, and they were what you want, a quality type of opponent to come in here and test your wits in an exhibition game like this.
Absolutely. And just give them credit. And we said this too, is like they're a scrappy team. Coach Seeley has done a great job with, building that program. And for us, I mean, it was about getting the butterflies out. I mean, you look at someone like Micah, who's the first time really playing and, rotating a lot of different players in. I mean, my gosh, we missed so many layups the first quarter that we got our head down, and you can't do that. And that's when we got defensive breakdowns and we weren't playing as hard, and they started, owning the tempo of being scrappier and things like that, kind of stealing our identity. So we had to really adjust and, get our head up and just play our game. Because they were playing hard all the time. I mean, they never stopped. So, I'm just proud of the 48 paint points. That's what keeps you in games, when you can kind of get it and pound it inside. And, we got to fix a lot in transition defense and things like that. But we got that always that first scrimmage is a tough one. It's just the lights are on, you're getting ready for the season, and the nerves are there.
And I would tell you, for an exhibition game, hey, the lower bowl almost nearly to a capacity here this afternoon. So
right.
It speaks a lot to the fans coming out here on Saturday afternoon for an exhibition game, getting some great support from the community.
Absolutely. And it carries on from last year. They're back, they're supporting this team, and their energy here, really helped us get going after halftime. And so we're so excited to be back. We're going to fix some things, but this was a great scrimmage. They were a great team to play against because of their style of play. And we're just looking forward to the season.
Got a lot of returners that are back with the squad. Mix in some new pieces who have either been with us and were unable to play last year, or newcomers to the program that we have not seen just yet. But when you're able to mix and match the types of players that you do, along with some of these gritty veterans that are returning, the G.G. Smiths, the Lacey Suggs, that gives you a lot of options. Almost too many options, Coach.
Yeah. There's a lot of depth, and so we're trying different things. Trying different things takes time and it takes patience, because you want to take this scrimmage and try things. We tried a lot of things, and a lot of things didn't work. And then some things did work and things like that. And some people are playing multiple positions. And, someone like Jess Munoz, who hasn't played in a year, and she's first time playing. I mean, so we've got the weapons. We just got to stay together and, like I said, compete on every possession. I think that is my biggest thing to them, and I'm preaching that all the time. Who cares if you make a mistake? Can you get back on defense? Can you talk louder? Can you get after it? I mean, I want to keep their confidence up. I felt like at times their confidence was a little down.
I know we'll talk about this throughout much of this year, but moving into the regular season and particularly conference play when that eventually gets underway, you're no longer the team that's going to be overlooked. You may have that kind of target take the Seahawks for granted. How does that message resonate with your team from top to bottom, knowing that you're no longer the necessary underdogs going into every night?
I think that their feel is that we're trying to continue this winning tradition. We are still kind of the underdog. So I said, don't put the pressure on you. Just be you and just, go out there and let's be us. And I think that the newcomers and players that didn't play last year are playing, and we're trying to still get other people in rhythm, and that's going to come. But as long as they stick together and they're positive and they don't really care who scores or they don't care who starts or who finishes, this could be a very, very special team. But they've got to buy in. They've got to be locked in. Our whole goal is to put a banner up this year. And so we're just going to keep fighting every day and get better.
Well, it's fun to watch, Coach. Thanks again for the time, and we'll catch up here
in
a little bit. It's road time now with
That's
a couple
right.
of big road games to start the year. Thanks again, Coach.
Thanks, and thanks all the fans for coming out. Thank you so much.